The prophetic voice amongst the chosen people had been silenced for several generations, and it is broken by the words of St. John the Baptist. And so, when the people sought to erect St. John the Baptist as the Messiah, he would clearly point out that one was coming who was greater than he. Indeed, he was unworthy to tie the straps of his sandals. Today, St. John confirms that message. When a dispute arises, he indicates very clearly that it is to the other that they must go, that is, it is to Christ, for it was Christ whom he came to announce as the fulfillment of all that was revealed to the chosen people of old, and hence the hope of the whole world. And so, St. John, wishing not to draw men to himself, but always throughout the whole of his life, wishing to witness to the coming of the Messiah, had the great privilege of being the one who would baptize the Messiah and thus sanctifying the waters for the greater baptism that was to come, that baptism which he would refer to. He baptized, he said, merely in water, but one who was coming would baptize in the Holy Spirit. And so, St. John witnesses to the historical reality of the coming of the Christ, and that he was truly greater than the greatest prophet that had come to the chosen people since Moses himself. And so, St. John indicates for us the complete fulfillment in Christ of all that was revealed by God, all that we can hope for. And so, he wished to direct all his disciples, all the chosen people, and ultimately all the world to the Christ, so that all may come to know him by incorporation into his mystical body, and there give him honor and praise, and recognize the Lord as the Prince of Peace. And so, we to this day rejoice that St. John the Baptist has pointed the way to us, and has truly revealed to us that this Christ was the one sent from the Father, and also equal with the Father from all eternity, true God and true man, who came into the world for the salvation of souls. And so, let us strive to spend our whole life reverence and honoring him, for the world has become forgetful of God, and so we must always keep his memory deep in our hearts and deep in our souls, striving always, as St. John would indicate to us, to recognize that we must always decrease so that Christ can always increase in us. And indeed, we see that most clearly in the Blessed Virgin Mary. For we can truly say of her, she was the most empty of all souls, because she was always empty and hence available to be filled with the love of God. She had none of the clutter of this world, none of the distractions that would keep her from God. She had a spot in her soul that was always awaiting more and more the grace of God, more and more the love of God. And so she would constantly grow in her love of God. And indeed, even in all eternity, Our Lady exceeds all the angels and saints in her love, reverence, and honor of the God who brought her into existence and bestowed upon her all those prerogatives which we recognize as members of the mystical body. And so, let us turn to our Mother so that she may help us to overcome all our sins, all that keeps us from that complete and total love of God, all that keeps us from recognizing what St. John the Baptist tells us, that we must always seek to decrease in order that Christ may always increase in us. And so, let us rejoice that this good Lord has come and has established things so well. Indeed, we can only marvel at the mystery of his church, how Christ has constituted it and made it available for all souls until the end of time. And so, let us pray that a world that for the most part essentially has gone unbaptized may again wake up, recognize that their visitation has come, and indeed They have been visited not by a mere man, but by their very God, in order that he may indicate to them the deep and profound love of the Blessed Trinity for each and every soul. For indeed, Christ comes in baptism to the individual soul and incorporates him into that most marvelous of all mysteries, that is, the mystery of his body, the Church on earth. And so, let us always rejoice with St. John the Baptist that we have Christ as our head, and if Christ is our head, then the world may be arrayed against us, but we have no reason to fear, for the one who leads is the one who is unassailable, the one who cannot be defeated, the one who John the Baptist pointed to, and the one that we must strive to point to each and every day of our lives, so that when we pass from this life, we enter into that eternal bliss of heaven where we can praise, reverence, and honor him in accord with all the angels and saints, thus augmenting the angelic choirs and the praise of God, that is, the very purpose for which we were created.
Christus.